Hello and welcome to this Hog 4 tutorial, which takes a look at the different options available when working across multiple pages. As a new addition to this series of tutorials, you can now use the times displayed to quickly navigate to an appropriate section of the video. Pages allow you to arrange your lists, scenes, and group inhibitive masters so that they can be quickly loaded onto the playback masters. Before we look at working across multiple pages, let's first take a look at what a single page has to offer. Every page has a main playback bar, which is attached to the 10 physical masters on your console. As you'll probably already know, a master can be chosen by either pressing the actual choose key or by touching the playback bar. Once a master has been chosen, it can then be controlled by the main playback keys on the front panel of the console. Each page actually has an additional 8 playback bars, which can be opened and closed by holding down PIG and pressing 1 through 8 on the keypad. The main playback bar is toggled using PIG and 0. This means you have 90 masters per page that you can use for lists, scenes, and group masters, and the additional playback bars behave exactly the same as the main playback bar. You can record directly to them, or move objects to them such as list, 1, move, and then press the master on the playback bar. Just like the main playback bar, with virtual playback bars you can still choose the master and use the main playback controls. Once any master is chosen, the main choose key can be used instead of pressing and holding down on the touchscreen. This allows you to easily change options on the choose toolbar, and also the intensity can be controlled by the last encoder wheel. If you have a playback wing attached to the console, then you can assign it to a playback bar in the control panel. Press Setup followed by Control Panel on the main toolbar, and then select the Wings tab. Select the wing from the appropriate drop-down menu, and then press Apply. This means the 10 physical masters on your playback wing will now control that playback bar. Each playback bar can also be opened and closed from this window, and the wing can be identified with this button. We can now move on to looking at how to create a new page. There are two ways to do this. Either type page 2 enter, or page 5 enter for example, or you can open the page directory and create the page there. To open the page directory, either double tap the page key or press and hold on an empty part of a display and select Pages from the menu. With Guard turned off, you can press a button in the directory to create the page. Press Set to give the page a name. With both methods, please note that when creating a new page, that page is immediately loaded onto the playback masters. To change page, you can use the Next Page and Back Page keys. This only moves between pages you have already created, so in this case, pages 1, 2, 5, and 7. The current page name is displayed to the left of the main playback bar and also to the right of the command line. The order that pages are loaded when using the Next and Back Page keys can be changed by reordering the pages in the page directory. Turn Guard back on, select the page, followed by Move, followed by the destination. There are different options available for what happens to active lists, scenes, and group masters when you change page. These options can be found in the Miscellaneous tab of Preferences. Press Setup, followed by Preferences from the main toolbar, followed by the Miscellaneous tab. The default option is Release All, which means that all lists, scenes, and group masters are released when changing to a different page. The Remember Fader Values options refer to the behavior of a fader when a list or scene is released. When turned on, the fader positions for intensity and scale values are remembered and recalled when returning to a page, even though the list or scene is released. The next page change option is Holdover if active, whereby active lists, scenes, and group masters are temporarily pinned to the incoming page until such time that they are released, at which point they are replaced with the object normally attached to that new page. It is worth noting that even when the option is set to release all, an object can be temporarily pinned to the incoming page by holding down its choose key whilst changing page. The third option is leave in background. This leaves the lists and scenes of the outgoing page active in the background and attaches the objects on the incoming page to the masters. Please note that group inhibitive masters do not remain active in the background and must therefore be attached to each page. A quick and simple way to achieve this is with the use of a template page. To create a template page, first of all, go to the page you wish to be the template. Please note that once a page has been set to be the template, it will be skipped when using the next and back page keys, so you may wish to copy the page first using the syntax page 1, copy 10, enter. In the pages directory, press the Set Current Page as Template button. You can also right-click on any page to set it as a template page. Once you have set up a template page, lists, scenes, and group masters on that template page will appear on every new page and all existing pages, so long as an object isn't already attached to the same master. If this is the case, the template object will be covered until the other object is removed from the page. Once removed, the template object will be attached to the master. Template objects by default are shown with a purple background. Finally, when changing page, a feature called Restore Activity can be used. This allows for the playback activity of a page to be quickly stored as a macro, so that when you return to that page, the same cues will be triggered and fader levels restored. To capture the activity of a specific page, in this case page 2, play the cues and scenes you wish to be later restored and also set their fader levels. Press Capture Activity in the page directory. This macro can then be disabled and enabled using the Toggle Current Page Activity button. The details of the macro can be viewed and edited in the spreadsheet view of this directory. Now if I release all playback, holding Pig and pressing Release, and pull the faders down, then when I advance by a page, and then go back again, you'll see that the same cues are played back and the faders are returned to their captured levels. In the next tutorial, we will take a look at how to use comment macros within lists and scenes. Thank you for watching.